Welcome back to Future Perfect. Young Filipinos have added another feather to the country's science and technology hat after the Philippine team bagged its first gold at the 5th International Earth Science Olympiad in Italy. The IESO is an annual world competition which tests the knowledge of participants in the different fields of geosciences, which covers geology, geophysics, meteorology, oceanography, terrestrial astronomy, and environmental sciences. And here to tell us more about their Italian experience, we have here in the studio Miguel Cano. He's a professor at the Bicol University and mentor of the participants. Willard Joshua Jose of the Philippine Science High School in Quezon City, Charles Kevin Chu of the St. Jude Catholic School, and John Allen Olesco from the Aquinas University. Thank you very much, gentlemen, for coming to Future Perfect, and congratulations.
Okay, thank you.
Fantastic. So, IESO basically is a competition for what? Budding geologists, weather professionals?
Yeah. That's what we hope to promote.
Yeah.
Like, we would like more people going into geosciences.
Yeah.
Because apparently there's a bit of problem of like students who would go into this profession.
Yeah.
It's worldwide, actually.
Uh-huh.
Like, there were, like, for example, in Japan, they're saying that those who are taking earth science fields are becoming less
declining
compared to like biology or chemistry,
yeah,
some other fields.
Mm.
So there's actually concerted efforts from among geoscience educators to really promote earth science.
And for yourself, what is your field?
I'm a geologist.
You're a geologist.
I'm a licensed geologist, yeah, but I've been to earth science education for more than a decade,
yeah,
starting as a science educator from UP NISMED.
Mm-hmm.
That's basically it.
Yeah. And how did you choose the students who would be participating in the IESO?
There's an annual exam. The first time it was held in 2007.
Okay.
It was held in Bicol because that's where the Earth Science Teachers Association of the Philippines is based.
Mm.
And they have a program of inviting schools over the CAR region.
Uh-huh.
And the first two contestants came from there, from the Bicol
region.
Not Bicol, but Baguio.
Baguio.
And then we thought that perhaps it's better to make it more national.
Mm-hmm.
So that's why we have several nodes, like we have in Legazpi,
yes,
we have in Davao, mm-hmm, and also in Baguio.
Mm-hmm. But you don't run out of students who would be joining the competition because, you know, if it's geosciences or the interest in geosciences is declining even in Japan, dito mm-hmm sa Philippines, hindi naman ganun.
I think we also have a problem. I'm speaking as a geologist,
yeah,
because we lack geologists,
geologists,
right? And even meteorology, we don't have the meteorology program is in the master's level. We don't have BS meteorology like in the United States or some other countries.
Okay.
I think we lack people going to those fields. Also
okay
in the Philippines.
Now, let's ask, of course, our young students here what their experiences were like. So, Willard, you're from the Philippine Science High School. What is your interest in geosciences? Which field are you actually more interested in?
I guess more on geology.
Geology.
Uh-huh. And the rocks.
And the rocks.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. Well, kasi kami dito sa studio, when we do say we're on the rocks, it's either we're drinking or mag-away kami. So, geology is parang your first line of interest. Huh? So, during the competition, because IESO, I guess that's where your preparation really was focused on. But there, as Miguel was saying before the show, you have to look at all the different disciplines, no, of geosciences. You've got meteorology, oceanography, terrestrial astronomy. I'll explain what that is later through you guys. So, how did you prepare for the other subjects?
Well, we had a general training of for 1 week intensive training,
mm-hmm,
I think one subject per day.
Wow, so cramming ba yun?
Not
kind of cramming, right?
I wouldn't say it's cramming. It's more of intense preparations.
Yeah. So how did you do in the Olympiad itself? I mean, what were you guys supposed to do? Okay, let's ask Charles. Well, during the actual competition, what stages or tests did you have to go through?
So there are two parts in the competition. Yeah. The first part is the practical exam. We had a practical exam.
Practical exam. So you're just testing your theoretical knowledge.
It's not really the theoretical part of the competition.
Yeah.
But it's more on the aspects of investigation, field investigation.
Oh.
So we have to go to the field. We have to go to different locations, and using equipment provided to us, we use these to answer some questions.
And you're talking about going to different fields in Italy.
In Italy,
yes. So we went to Venice actually.
For the hydrology
experiment.
Hydrology, meaning to say, measuring the level of water,
temperature of water.
The temperature of water. Wow, ang paka exotic naman ng location ng test niya. Nag gondola ba kayo habang ginagawa niya?
Actually, we're in a yacht.
Oh, wala pa lang sinabi ng mga nasa yacht pa. Okay, so you had to do practical field tests.
Okay. Then the second part of the contest is the written examination or a theoretical examination.
So that's where the theoretical comes in,
and that is a long examination. If I'm not mistaken, that's 4 hours, I think. So.
Just in one day, four hours straight. For all of the disciplines.
For all the disciplines. Geosciences. And we have to choose, or we have to answer in paper instead.
In 4 hours. So, Alan, from Aquinas University. Okay. What is your specific interest in geosciences? Willard says geology. Charles, what is yours?
Meteorology.
Meteorology, and yours is?
I like astronomy, but I also like geology.
So you like looking at heavenly bodies.
Yes.
Yeah, that's what we like too. Yeah, that's why we had Shamsi Soup here for a while. Anyway, so you like astronomy. What kind of field test did you have to do when you were in Italy for astronomy?
We had to operate the telescope.
A telescope. Okay. And was this in an observatory?
No. Kind of.
Kind of an observatory. Okay. Where was the entire Olympiad held?
In Modena.
In Modena. But what was it? It's like a university?
Yeah, it's based in the University of
Modena.
We call it Unimore.
Unimore.
Unimore, or I don't know.
Unimore. Yeah. So you're interested in astronomy. So what kind of field tests did you do? I mean, Charles is saying you measured the temperature of the water in Venice. And what about you?
Well, we did a lot of stuff for geology. We actually identified some rocks, identified some fossils.
Yeah, but what about the astronomy
for
part?
Astronomy,
your favorite
we
part?
Just yeah. We operated a
telescope.
And we. That was a difficult.
Were you supposed to be able to locate a particular star?
Or? We had to point it directly at the sun, because it was solar observation.
Isn't that dangerous?
No,
point it directly at the sun.
There's a filter, a solar filter.
Just like Google, they have filters. All right, well, fantastic. So it started out in Bicol, you said, right? And since then. We've actually participated in.
No, it's in Baguio. In 2007.
Sorry, did you say Bicol or Baguio? Yeah, Baguio.
Baguio,
right. So it started in Baguio, and each year we've been sending teams to participate.
Okay. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And this is the first time that we had a gold in the competition, right?
Yes.
Yeah. So does that mean that we actually learned already from the previous Olympiads, and that's why we've managed at least to improve our performance?
Yeah, I believe so, because that's the reason why it's very important you attend pre-Olympiad conferences. Mm-hmm. That's why for the actual Olympiad in September, I had to go to Modena in July for the pre-Olympiads, because you'll be given, you'll be oriented on how the Olympiad would go.
Olympiad works, yeah.
And actually, that would put you in an advantage, because basically you know how to prepare the students.
Yeah, especially for the field work, right?
Yeah, exactly.
I mean, because they need to know exactly the kind of environment that you'll be operating in. Mm-hmm. So for geology, okay, I'll go back to Willard. For geology, that's what you like. And you went to Italy. What? Did they ask you to go to Mount Vesuvius to get volcanic rocks? Or what did they ask you?
There were a lot of stuff that they asked us to do, measure the strike and dip of a certain geological feature and then identify fossils in the rock and then identify the rock and mineral types of the samples they give.
And these are actual you know, locations in Italy where they have fossil beds, right? Which place of part of Italy did you go to?
It's just in Modena.
It's so still in Modena.
Yeah.
So yung sayo mas maganda. So Venice. You get to go to the most exotic spot for your part of the test, huh? And you know, after they go through the Olympiad, what do they take away from the event? I mean, does it actually add more to their practical knowledge of geosciences?